I congratulate the chief, new chief executive officers who took their oaths of office this morning to lead government, ministries, and corporations over the next 3 years. You have been called to serve your God, your country, and your people, and to do so with humility and commitment. As the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others, as reaffirmed by your declaration to dutifully serve. We are all public servants, and our role is to serve our people without fear and partiality. Hence, discard the fears in your mind and be led by the dreams in your heart. Let go of worrying about what you cannot control. Shift your energy to what you can create. Above all, do not fear change when change becomes necessary so to do. Following a number of crises in the past, this government has not shied away from the introduction of and leading public sector reforms in order to strengthen public sector functions and performance. Such reforms led to term contracts for heads of government ministries on a 3-year term basis, separation of regulatory from service delivery functions, establishment of state-owned enterprises, and the introduction of a credible tendering process for all government projects, to name a few. To date, government continues to push for reforms in all sectors of our economy to ensure that the skills and knowledge base are fit for purpose and good governance principles are followed, and that the use of our scarce resources are maximized. My advice to you all is, it is only after you have stepped outside your comfort zone that you begin to change, grow, and innovate. In the discharging of your duties and responsibilities, you will be looked upon for direction and for decisions, and to set good examples for your staff. You will remain a public figure and under the constant scrutiny of the public. While the appeal of the new role may dissipate with time, pause to stop and appreciate who you are and what you have achieved, and perhaps learned through a few mistakes, stumbles, and losses, you actually can enhance everything about you. That's how you gain experience, which is defined as learning from your past mistakes. Self-acknowledgement and appreciation are what give you the insights and awareness to move forward towards higher goals and accomplishments. Incidences in the past involving CEOs reaffirm the fact that the moment CEOs become complacent and indifferent in the performance of their duties, That may well spell the beginning of their downfall. Take heed of the example from the scriptures when Saul, the first ever king of Israel, who was perfect in form and command, powerful and fearless, but when he ignored God's commandment and wise counsel, he was stripped of the honor of a great leader, and even chose his successor to become a live thorn on his side for the remainder of his reign. Behold in your decision making, be bold in your decision making. Cabinet cannot afford to delay decisions at the expense of the country waiting due to your failure to provide the necessary advice when so required. Delegate and share your workload with your management and staff. But always follow up. Delegation is a beautiful and great management tool to improve your organization's efficiency and avoid procrastination. It is also a great process to raise capacity and on the job training of your assistants. But if you do not proactively follow up, none of your instructions will be executed. And the great delegation of duties, virtues, will be rendered absolutely useless. Have a good ear. Listen to the views of others, as they will assist to good and informed decision making. Be visionary and innovative, as your role is to think strategically on what is best for Samoa, for the present and future generations. Always, always be forward-looking in your thinking. As I have reiterated time and time again, my office is always packed with people traveling from all over the country, come and see me every day. They even come to my home before and after hours. Many of their requests fall directly under the responsibilities of the relevant ministers and CEOs. And I'm often told that my office is the last means, or is the means of last resort. And you are all extremely busy doing very nice and useful things. And you have no time to see our people. We are accountable to our people. So I would ask you that you also practice an open door policy. You thoroughly enjoy it. Who will not enjoy talking to God every hour of the day through the people that you allow to come to your office with their problems? That's what our reverends and priests and pastors tell us, that the holy temple of God is in you, is your body. When you are hard pressed from all directions, and when trials and tribulations unfold before you, along the way allows space for meditation and the power of prayer, even for a few seconds, for the Lord is always there before you, judging you every second of the day. Ensure that you maintain good health and welfare. If you fall sick through overwork, then it proves my point that you are really stupid and you should never have accepted the appointment. I wish you all the best in your calling and journey as CEOs. May the abundance of God's grace, favor, and blessings be upon you always, and may you never have a private phone, and that you answer your telephones extra quickly. God bless Samoa Soifua.